Hi, this is Bob Johnson from Bob Johnson Computer Stuff, and if you're looking for an online Toughbook community that gives tips, tricks, and support, hit that subscribe and notification bell so that we can tell you about all of our upcoming videos. Today, I'll be unboxing a gift from our friends over at Durabook, so stay tuned. What do we got? Ooh, we have foam packing on the top. Ooh, a real cool looking box here. So they had this inside of this brown box for protection with some foam. So this is the shipping box. And this is the Durabook box. What a cool box, look at that. Z14. All right, so it looks like Durabook, any time mission calls. So let's take a look what we got. All right, so I'm going to pull this out. Let's see how I'm going to do this. First thing I'm going to pull out is this box here. This looks like, this probably has the accessories in it. We got it taped shut, so I'm gonna just pop it open. What do we have here? We have a, this looks like a screen cleaner, so you can buff up your screen. And then they have a little card here that kinda gives me a quick start guide on everything that's on the unit, as well as what's in the package. So they're telling me there's a laptop PC, AC adapter, power cord, and lithium ion battery. So let's take a look and see what else we have. So this is all packed up. This looks like the battery. It's in a nice bubble wrap package. Let's see. I'm gonna pop it out. So here's the battery, and it's telling me on the quick start guide, install the battery. And it gives me a little instruction list. So that will be whenever we pull the laptop out. And then here's the AC adapter. This is the power cord that goes to it. And this is the adapter itself. This is probably the stylus tether for the touchscreen. I'll bet you 10 to 1 that's what that is. It's not on my list of things in the box, but that's okay. This is the, oh, there's the stylus. So this probably attaches it to the laptop so you don't lose it. And this is the AC adapter. It's a pretty light AC adapter for, from what I'm, you know, what I compare it to, like the Panasonic, a little lighter. And then this is the cord that would plug in to the wall. I'm gonna pull this out so we have it. And put this on the side for now. I'm gonna move this box out of the way. So, now, the only thing left in here, what's in here is a couple of foam packings, so I'm gonna pull the laptop out and they're probably gonna come out with it. There we go. And then it just, if you look inside here, this is where this box pulled out of, this box here pulled out of this little cutout right here. I don't know if you can see that. But otherwise, the box itself is pretty sturdy. I like the design of it. It's really nice. As compared to a brand new Panasonic Toughbook box, this is actually fancy. So, and on the side here, they have what's in the box and all the little specs of that particular laptop. So I'm just gonna set this on the side and we're gonna pull these foam. Wow, it is a hefty laptop, that is for sure. I'm gonna put these in the box over here. Now they wrapped it in a piece of plastic, held down with two pieces of tape. I'm just going to pull that tape off. There it is. Wow. It is a hefty laptop. So this is the laptop. Here's the top. It's got a nice Durabook logo. Rubber bumpers on the side. Feels really sturdy. I love the feel of the handle. Check it out. It's like a, it's got like this rubberish, smooth feeling for as a handle. I don't know how to describe it, but it's really comfortable and it's flexible. You know, kind of unlike that Toughbook, the CF-31 or even the 53 or 54, theirs is just a solid piece of metal. This actually flexes to fit your hand pretty nice. That's a nice feature. So what I'm going to do next is open it up. And here it is. Looks like it has a screen protector that it says right here. It says, so it looks like it has a little screen protector on it. And it says here, step one, peel off this mask. So I'm just going to do step one and peel this off. Wow. And that's the screen. Look at this. It's a widescreen touch screen. That's nice. You know, it has a nice matte finish to it. This right in here is pretty pretty sturdy. There's a little webcam that's up here. I have this keyboard, and it's a backlit keyboard. In fact, let me see. There's going to be a packing list. Let's take a look at the packing list on this unit so we can see what the specs are. Here's the packing list right here. Let me pull this out. Might be. So the packing list right here, I'm going to read this off to you. So this is what Durabook sent us. It's a nice little surprise present for us so we can let you guys see it. This is a Durabook Z14. So this is their fully rugged laptop. It's got a 14-inch 1920 by 1080 sunlight readable screen. It's touch screen. It's 1,000 nits. If you need to know what a nit is, we do have an article on our website that talks about that. It's an Intel i7 8th gen, 16 gigs of RAM, a 256 gig SSD. It has, of course, your wireless and Bluetooth cards, 4G LTE, GPS, and RF passthrough. There's a 2-megapixel front camera. This is a backlit keyboard. It has your PCMCIA Type 2 slot plus an Express card slot, Express card 54 slot. It's got RFID, fingerprint scanner. Wait, let me see where that fingerprint scanner is. Dun, dun, dun. Fingerprint scanner. Okay. It's right here. So it has a fingerprint scanner right here. That's pretty cool. Smart card reader, CAC. Super multi DVD RW drive, which is right in one of these ports. We'll get to that. I'll open the port so you guys can see it. It's got a docking port, which would be on the bottom. It has 4 USB, an audio. It has audio with 2 RJ45 Lan jacks, which is pretty nice. It's got HDMI out, VGA standard. It's got an RS232 serial port. Wow, still putting that port on these laptops. It's got a main battery, which we're going to install next. This is a 90-watt AC adapter. It comes with Windows 10 Professional 64-bit. And the 3-year Durabook accidental bumper-to-bumper warranty coverage. Not bad, not bad. So let's see where the battery goes. The battery is right here. I'm just going to pop it open. It goes in there. Yep. You know, these doors have a nice neoprene or rubber foam right here that when you close it, you got to press it in a little bit. That's not bad. I guess that's to make it waterproof. And this is our battery. So I'm just going to look down in there, make sure it's clear. And I'm going to put the battery in. Looks like it's going to go this way like this. Battery's in. And you know, interesting enough, if you look right here, the battery also has a foam end on it, which I guess gives it a little protection to keep it always plugged in. Now I'm going to just fix this little pull tab that would pull the battery out. And wow, you got to push it in. There we go. So now we have the battery in. Let's take a look at the ports. So that's where the battery went, and this looks like where we have some USB ports. There's one, two, three USB ports. It even has an HDMI port there, and this is where your PCMCIA Type 2 slot is and your express card slot. Interestingly enough, they aren't spring-loaded latches. You have to actually physically move it, and then when you close it, you got to physically move it back over. On the back here, you have your power port. This is where we can plug in a power. And then right here is, look at that, two RS-232 jacks right out there. And there's my two RJ45 jacks with the VGA port. And here's a display port for the HDMI out. So if you have those HDMI monitors, you're good to go. On this side, we have our DVD RW with the smart card reader right above it. And then there's the SIM card slot, SD card slot, looking pretty good. I'm gonna close that up. And then over here is where the hard drive sits. It's right inside here. And I'm just gonna pull it out and see what it looks like. It also has that rubber end as well. Let's take a look. Yep, 256 gig SSD installed. It's very lightweight. Not much to it, but then the SSD doesn't need a lot of protection because there's no moving parts. It has a nice foam end here so that it stays installed even while, I guess, in, you know, being bumped around and whatnot. So that's in. So basically, this is a nice book right here. I think it would be comparable to like the Panasonic Toughbook CF-31. It has a lot of nice features that the 31 doesn't have or didn't come with. The fact that it's got the front-facing camera right here, that's a nice feature as compared to the 31. I also like because it has this wide screen, so we have this nice 14-inch wide screen, whereas, you know, as you know, that Toughbook CF-31 has that 13-inch standard screen. It is still daylight readable. One downside to this as compared to the 31 is that the daylight readable screen on the 31 is a 1200 nit, whereas this is a 1000 nit. Shouldn't keep you from buying it though. 200 nit is not going to make or break your daylight readability. It comes with your backlit keyboard, whereas that's an upgrade option for the 31. Now, some of the things that I didn't like just from a first look is I'm not in love with these doors, these little latch doors. I'm gonna have to get used to them. I'm kind of used to the fact of whenever I close it, it clicks. This one I actually have to take, close and push the latch over. I don't know if I like it or not yet. I'm gonna let you know that in future videos. Also, I noticed that the doors are not as rugged feeling as the Panasonics are. The Panasonic doors on the 31 feel more substantial than these doors. Again, it's just my first impressions. I'll be giving you more videos as we move along, as the weeks move along, and tell you how I feel after I've used this for a little while. Well, I guess that's about all I got for you today. Don't forget to leave your comments in the comments section. Let me know what you think. And if you've bought one of these, tell me what your opinion is. Other than that, I'll see you next week.